Hi there guys, I'm Peter, founder and MD of Content 45.
Hi, my name is Alex and I'm the creative director here.
We're a dynamic social media agency helping people realize how powerful social media and content communications are within our digital era we live in.
That's a good question. How did it all start?
That's a very good question. Well, putting it on the simplest of terms, both I and Alex are advertising and marketing fanatics. We see how influential social media, copy, marketing, and about communications are within our era of business and social today. Me being only 22 years old, both at a year out of uni here, I've always had a passion for media and business joined together ever since the age of 15.
I remember since I was a kid I wanted to do advertising. And then in university I meet this guy. And a few years later when we are in London, I was doing freelance. He comes up to me and he says he has an idea. And that's how I joined on board.
Yep, definitely. This guy's been my right hand man, you could say, so I really love that. The passion for social media came from me doing some voluntary work for a magazine brand, where I'm managing the day-to-day posting, campaign management, and marketing outreach to the social media extent. However, after 8 months of me doing social media posting, looking over my consistency, creativity, and dedication, I realized I was getting really good at social posts. Then one night it came to me, if I put the work ethic on a horse, I managed to specialize in a skill that my peers take for granted, and most importantly, I'm an ambitious and hardworking person. Why not offer my service out to help others with? Since then, I was up to ridiculous thousands of money, wouldn't even want to think of drafting up business ideas on how this is going to work. And if I had not promoted several plans, what was the answer? Content 45. The content, that's pretty obvious to do with social media, pictures, videos, blog articles, you name it. In terms of 45, the number 45 means preservation or problem to be solved. Now, if you look at the hectic, always up and down business owner, barely any of them have time for social media, be able to update their company pages. So as a result, they have to outsource that out to an agency or hire a social media guy or someone so fanatic to even manage that. Instead of you doing that, why not outsource it out to someone that does have time for that, specializing in it? That's why I believe that if I join content and 45 together, I pretty much come up with a solution. So there you go.
Well, and after he told me all the idea, and I did love it, I went out to do the logo for us. For the main idea was that it's so many things social media is, and how can you squeeze everything into probably something people are going to look for 5 to 10 seconds or so. We had to stand out, we had to be very happy, and at the same time be almost like a friend who you can rely on all the time. The rationale behind the drawings was always the exciting part, because for me that was always the most important part of any idea generation. It always starts with a pencil and a paper. There is nothing else. You have to start there, and this is where it got us.
Exactly, because everything that is very phenomenal or very mind-blowing in this world today always started out with something simple. It's a simple idea, so as long as you all take simple ideas, you can turn it into something of value and offer something to share with the world. $5. Well, that's what he's the creator.
I'm
a steward because I haven't really got I've that's what I want to do. I want to be able to grow something in which is the real value and obviously share it with like-minded people, like my right-hand man, you say.
Well, there has been a lot of talks in the couple of last years. We were a bit shaky. Yeah, they were a bit shaky. That's the thing, you can't stop if something, if something goes wrong, you can't just quit, you can't just stop and say, oh, I've tried this for an hour, I failed, that's it, I'm done. Yeah, you can't stop after trying something for an hour, for a day, for a week. It doesn't work that way. You have to try every day for at least a month. Christ, a month, probably a year, half a year, it doesn't matter. It's, you have to, if you try hard enough, you will get it. Mm-hmm. It will not take a day, two, three, it might even take more than 1 year. Mm-hmm. But if you work hard at it, I think you'll make it.
Yeah, it's accurate. It's accurate, because I do know the saying, that, for example, the saying goes to, the body achieves what the mind believes. If I believe in my mind that I can be able starting off myself, I mean action towards it, then you would actually be, take whatever action is. Don't be afraid to be different. So even if you're out there and you've got a really great idea and you have to share it with the world, share it with the right like-minded people. Don't share it just anyone, because not everyone in this world may be happy for you or may be happy to hear your dreams. So you just got to be genuine, know who to network with, and if one day start to grow something out for yourself. Because that's how you just set yourself apart from the crowd. Any advice I would say? You gotta be bold, you gotta stand out, you gotta be resilient, but you gotta be daring.
That's true advice. Well, something that I would have appreciated hearing way earlier, probably just when I started, is don't get too attached to your process, the way you do things. Don't try to put everything in the template.
Of course.
People are creatures of routine. We all are. Mm-hmm. But say the next time you get a client, don't stick with the same process. Go out, go to a different place. Start looking in a different place. I don't know, even something like a cafe, for God's sake, if that's what it is. Sometimes talk to a person in line. I mean, this world is so huge. It's filled with people of different cultures, nationalities, and you can't read all about all that from your smartphone or a book. You can't do it. You have to go out and find it all out for yourself. We can look at something simple. We can look at a leaf, for God's sake. Beetle will say something different, I'll say something different. There are so many different opinions out there. Don't be afraid to go and find them. And at the same time, don't be afraid to share yours. There are people all over the world interested in books, science, psychology, music, whatever it is. There are like-minded people out there. And thankfully, with all the technology now, you can, upload a video. Upload a video of, the interesting fact that you read today. And there will be people who will enjoy it. Okay, there will be some people who will hate it. They will say, oh, he's terrible, blah, blah, blah.
Everyone has a different viewpoint.
Everyone, it doesn't mean it's bad. Unless you count some Star Wars movies. But apart from that, it's all gonna be fine. You can't be afraid of someone saying something bad. If you're afraid of that, well, you have to stop being, because there will be people who will hate it, either who will be disgusted, who
manage to grow together or share ideas. Like, for example, we are generation literally like Y or even Z, so we're classed as the millennials. Now the millennials, they are very enterprising, so we are very creative and we're surrounded by a whole technological boom. Now, for example, the internet is a very vast virtual playground, and it's your opportunity, it's your responsibility as doctors to find out what works for you and how you can manage to make the most of it to actually accomplish your dreams. And what better way to actually find out about your dreams than obviously networking with the right people, going on the internet, obviously not doing it for the wrong reasons. Now, for example, probably 30, 40 years ago, there was no such thing as YouTube. So it's a case of people now make money off YouTube. That's because they found out that they're very open-minded, very charismatic, they're extroverts. People, even for example, ladies, they go online, they manage to make videos and post on YouTube about makeup tutorials, fashion, because they know what they're talking about or they're passionate about what they do. Just like me and Pushkin, we're passionate about what we're doing and we want to be able to share that with others. So always be yourself, though. Always be passionate and don't be afraid to be different.
I saw damn finger.
That's because I'm trying to address you. So it's the case where you've got to not be afraid to be different, because you've got to make sure you stand out from the crowd. When you stand out from the crowd, I know that's a cheesy saying, probably may have heard secondary school, very cliche. But literally, that saying actually holds value. Stand out from the crowd, but it's easier said than done, because a lot of people experience peer pressure as a young person. Maybe, for example, they're going to a party. Maybe, for example, people are obviously, they're drinking or maybe they're smoking. But you want to be different. You've got to learn to be different. And say to yourself that you are of value. You want to offer something to the world. You want to be able to stand out. Once you can do that, then that's when people will come to respect you. The right like-minded people. So, like I said, be different, be passionate, be resilient, and be bold in achieving your dreams.